All right. So our next performer coming up to the mic, I am so excited because he's been rocking with us since CNA Cafe. I've watched him grow as a poet. I've watched him literally graduate, and now he is an educator and a teacher. So give it up for John Gifted.
Can you hear me clearly?
Yeah.
Holding the mic is gonna be a little bit important, so I'm gonna place it here. Oops, all right. How's everybody doing? Good. Everybody's ready to vote?
Yeah.
I just became a citizen, so now I can vote. I felt tricked. I don't know who to vote for. All of them are a bunch of pun artists. I mean, here's a question. Can you tell the difference between the letter I, the capital letter I, and the lowercase letter L? Think about it. Can you tell the difference between the capital letter I and the lowercase letter L when you actually type it? Can you tell the difference? You can't tell the difference, just like the majority of us, we can't tell the difference of our so-called politicians. They all asking for the same thing, they all wishing to give us the same thing, but in the back of their mind, they have a different agenda. But anyways, that's just politics. Politics are for our kids. Anyways. So, we're gonna start off with this. All right, I haven't performed in a while. I have some new material, so we're gonna get with this. All right, now let's see. All right. She is a timeless beauty, accompanied with such graceful elegance that time itself freezes to worship the like of her wonders. Her smile is deadlier than a nymph's siren, for it captures the gazer within and consumes him whole. Her eyes' solemn twinkle kiss the moon's twilight as it set on the orient. Even beauty gets jealous and envious at the thoughts of just her name being whispered. She is the masterpiece locked in the artist's mind that he refuses to reveal to the world out of pity of ever letting go. She is the rose blossoming in the vivacity of the fool's moon bliss. And rarity has become so synonymous to her appeal that it uses her as a muse. She is beyond the comprehension of logic, nor is she impossible to retain. Her only joys lie in the presence of the present. She is too delicate to be held and too fragile not to be clutched. She brings forth the misery of truth while kissing away the torment of the uncertainty. And his heart only desires to encapsulate all the poems inside of her that paper cannot handle. She gives meaning to the alphabet and brings life to the poetry through her loving heart. And through her, he could see the sound of the music and hear the colors of the rainbow. Through her, he can see the sound of the music and hear the colors of the rainbow like a psychedelic trip down into the rabbit hole. And if there ever was a moment that life needed to escape realism and imitate art, he would write a drastic poetry about her, which is a work of art, about a work of art. And it was only in that instant that things started to make sense. He was losing his forsaken mind about her being as priceless as each breath of life needed to be taken. If only she would remember that to him, she was an art piece. I'm telling you.